So macroinvertebrates are not just an important part of a trout diet, but also can help us tell the health of a stream or just about any body of water. In just a moment, I'm going to grab a sample from this creek right here. This is Prairie Creek in Prairie Creek Redwood State Park. And we're going to take a look at what organisms are living in this stream right here.
Now, before I begin, it's important to understand what a macroinvertebrate is. So this word is basically two parts, macro and invertebrate. So a macro is anything that you can see with your naked eye. So without using a microscope or a magnifying glass, you can see these things. Invertebrates are any organism that does not have a backbone. So if you feel your back right now, you'll feel little bumps along your spine. Those are called your vertebrae, and that's what makes you a vertebrate. All the organisms that we're looking at today don't have a backbone. They might have some other type of skeleton, and many of them have their skeletons on the outside, exoskeletons, but they don't have a backbone like you or me.
So today I'm going to be collecting my sample with a D-net or a dip net, and you can see this has a really fine mesh so that way any macroinvertebrates aren't going to be able to slip through it. Some of the organisms that you'll look for to have a healthy stream are things like caddisfly larvae, mayfly nymphs, dragonfly nymph, stonefly nymph. These are organisms that are essentially, these are baby versions of things you might see flying around. So when we say we use the macroinvertebrates to determine the health of the stream, what we're essentially doing is looking at the ecosystem that these organisms prefer. And what we're looking at is the organisms who are picky about their environment and prefer the same environment that trout do, or that the fish do. Generally, these are considered sensitive organisms, that if there's any big change in their environment, that they're not gonna be able to deal with that. Inversely, what we see in an unhealthy stream, we see a lot of organisms that are generalists, organisms that don't necessarily mind what kind of ecosystem they're living in. Part of the reason that macroinvertebrates are so helpful is they have a relatively short lifespan. So we're able to see any change in an environment relatively quickly and how that affects generations of this organism. So if there's any change in this ecosystem, we're able to take a look at the organisms living here, and the species that live here will shift pretty rapidly if there's a big change in the environment. Seeing the organisms in this stream does not only tell us that this is a healthy stream, but also means that this ecosystem can support fish, like trout, because their food source is here, and that's incredibly important. Thank you guys so much for spending some time with me and my bugs.
Let's say bye to all of our buggy friends.